Onigashimasu. Welcome back to the nearly world famous Garage Dojo on a beautiful Sunday afternoon in Johnson City, Texas. Today I'm going to be working through the kata Seiuchin with you. Seiuchin is an interesting kata, even by Dojiru means. There are no kicks in this kata whatsoever. Most of it's done in a very slow and deliberate fashion. I tell my students that when you get out to run Seiuchin, it's you and your presence are what are most important, because there's nothing flashy about it. It's a lot of really strong, grounded stances, some very interesting hand movements. So it's just you and your presence that gets the attention of an audience or judges or a grading panel. So what you want to practice when you're doing this kata is not only understanding the moves that you're doing, but also to present, to hold that space yourself, to make sure that your energy, your chi, is actually radiating out maybe 9 feet in all directions from your body. That's harder to do than it seems. You have to really practice on settling yourself down, holding that space, and not being in any hurry. It's a very patient kata too. This kata is really meant to, through the multiple use of shikadachis, to strengthen the hips, particularly the quads, the glutes, right through the hip connectors, because there is a number of shikadachi stances where you are deep and you're holding them while you go through some movements. There are a number of times where we're coming straight in and straight back. So that in and out constantly is working on the strength of your hips. This shikadachi stance is many times getting lower than our opponent, being able to move from that stance to this stance very easily, and being lower and more grounded than our opponent, which makes us harder to unbalance and makes it easier for us to unbalance them. So we used to laugh that when we were running this, sensei a lot of times would leave us in this stance, you know, for 15 minutes it seemed like, while he walked around and corrected people. And you knew he was in the back of the dojo, and your legs would be doing, we used to call it sewing machine legs. Your legs would start shaking and was so tired, but you think, okay, it's safe for me to move, so you, and you'd hear, Mr. Pounds! So like he had eyes in the back of his head. And part of the method to his madness for leaving us in those stances was, again, that building up of that strength. So so the things you want to think about are your own presence, your own projection is very important, which is also very important in self-defense. You know, the feeling of being grounded and of being all here is very deterring many times to the attacker. And it's very empowering to us. So that's one thing we're working on a lot in this kata. So I'm going to go through it, and then we can talk about some of the parts of it. So, like many goju katas, it'll start with three of the same move. So, Seiuchin! Stepping out, 45 degree angle, settling the weight. Slight pause here, pushing out and around, back of the hands together. Let them separate naturally here. Both hands out, turning away from each other. Sukuyuke, sweeping block, grab kakie, and bringing this nukite right into the ribs as you pull an opponent in. Same thing second time, try not to raise up when you move, try to keep that height. Slight pause of pushing down and settling, push forward off balance, bring in, down, hands open and turn away from each other, There's that nuketay. Third one, same as the first. Here, push, come around, down, out, grab and pull in. Circle this hand down, this fist down onto the open palm, stay low, and this is going right into the upper solar plexus. Then immediately, right there. Keeping connection with the hand, bring this fist down, turning at a 45 degree angle, making sure we go to the outside of the shoulder, and strike, 180, strike. Same thing this way, one, coming forward, two, three, one, two. Very quick sweep, check sweep, rocket. Stepping across in bent Sukhadachi, just dropping, and we're going in this angle this time. Each knee, san, keying all, keying all the way through that. One, two. Bent Sukhadachi across, double block, boom. One, and back out again. One, two. Bring it back here. Circling around. And back. So, these kata, let me go through some of the moves. It would help if I had a partner to demonstrate, but I think I can talk us through it. So as we start in, someone's grabbed our wrist. So we settle down at an angle. We get the angle on them. Settle. Now when we push in, that locks them back a little bit, and we come around. They still have our wrist up here. And when we start down, they start pulling against that here, and then we can headbutt or whatever. But they are having to react to our movements while they're still trying to hold on to our wrists, which starts putting them at the end of the whip, so to speak. So from here, the push down is settling, push toward them, back around, back of the hands. Let them separate naturally. Look at the kime right at the end there. Kime, I open both hands. They turn away from each other. Sukuyuke, under the arm. Kakie, grabbing. Pull them into this strike, which is a spear hand right into the ribs. Right between the ribs, actually. Here, same thing with the same move. Settle. Pushing them away, bringing them in. Settling down, open the hands, skuyuke, and nukite. Same thing for the third. So that is a repeat of the same pattern a number of times. As we get to the end of the last one, skuyuke, kakie, bringing them in. So here, just like landing an airplane on a aircraft carrier, for instance. So we're here, here. Stay low, don't bob up, like so. So this is these two knuckles. We used to call this the CPR strike. So if you can put this against somebody's sternum or just below it and then just pulse like that, and it will knock them backwards a couple of feet and they'll be gasping for breath. So that move, we're laying it on them really, and then everything at once like an electric shock. So this is augmented right there. These two knuckles are what's against the upper solar plexus. And then a pop, very strong, very strong. So as we're here, next move up here. Next move is bringing it down, next opponent, right there, or the angle we want to take on the opponent. Circular augmented block. Two bunkais for this. One is the augmented block. Very strong opponent, and one arm's not enough, so you need both arms making sure that it goes all the way across the body to the other shoulder, okay? Another bunkai, that is a slap at the same time that you're blocking. Bam! We don't show that, but that can be either one. Now, if we are blocking against a very strong opponent, and we go to take our hand away to strike, he's going to overpower our hand, right? So we have to keep that augmentation hand there, push into them, last minute it comes off. You take it off too soon, they're strong, they're going to destroy our stance. So here, think augmentation, strong opponent. Now as you push into them, that hand comes off. Striking to the groin area, immediately back, 180. So that's what we're doing. We're just doing it at this angle. So in the kata, it looks like this. Let me get where we can see this. The augmented block, this stays till the last second. One and two. Same thing to this side. Augmented block. Good Sanchin stance, very strong here. Okay, now I'm not going to take this hand off until the very end. Come here, and one, and back. All right, so very important, block to the outside shoulder. I mean, don't stop here, in other words. Cross, hand stays on to the very minute when your foot hits into that new shikadachi going into your opponent. So, next move from here, if you visualize a punch coming to the face, the first thing we're doing is going here, capturing the wrist, and this is actually a strike, or it could be a strike and grab of the groin area, lower solar plexus groin area. So it's very important when you're here, visualize a punch coming to your face, and that'll set this X block, this jujiuki, up very strongly, perfect here. Then we capture the wrist, pull them off balance into us, and we strike with our, we do this twice. Second one, here, pow, like so. So both of these start with blocking a punch to the face and capturing the hand, the wrist of your opponent, pulling them in. So, let me see if I can do this sideways. Can't remember where I am. That happens a lot. If I'm talking my way to your top, I'll forget where I was. So, from here, there's the block, the capture, boom, pulling them off balance and striking. Same with the other side, block the punch, grab, bam, pull in. Okay, so in the kata, we're going straight back from here. One, two, three, four. This actually has your opponent's punching hand in as you pull them back and off balance. So this is, some people think this is just a block up here. But you actually, anything returning to the body usually has something in it. So in this case, it has your opponent's striking or punching hand here. Bam, like so, you pull them off balance. So they're stumbling into the strike. So we're here. Next move from here, a big strong ashibarai, but we stop on a dime there. If you visualize an attack coming like this, you see it coming, take the leg and the block right there. Soto uriuke. So these hands, foot and block same time. Then, very quickly, check the sweep. One. Suriachi, step pull up. So, that again looks like this. Here, and then. Okay? So now we're in this position. This hand is open and against the wrist, just augmenting that. But this strike is uraken. Okay? I've seen some people do it like an uppercut. And in reality, you could use either one. This one's very strong. Now we're going to change directions by design. So here I'm looking over my shoulder to my future, and then I pop. So I'm in a left Sanchin Dachi now. So this hand comes up to the obi, So this hand turns over and pulls down their lead hand. Boom. Comes back to here. Right. And then one. So let me start to show that at another angle. Okay, so we're here. Right here. Cross. Bang! So that's what it looks like from that particular angle. This is a continuous flow of techniques. Once you've turned to here, top hand, this one comes up only because you don't want to be swinging from your knees with that uppercut. And the uppercut goes to the body. That's much better target. When you hit them, this comes forward and then the uppercut travels on up and takes the chin. But don't aim for the chin. Very easy to miss that target. People good at slipping. So, boom, 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 right? One, two, three. And that's one kiosk. So it's like this. Hey, hey, and back out. Boom. Like so. So you notice the whole time I'm trying to keep very good, strong, and deep shikadachi. So you got this kata, chest out over my center. The more you can work on this stance with chest out, it's very important to keep you over your center, you know, instead of being like this or leaning back, very weak that way. So work on it, work on it, work on it. And this kata will work you on that numerous times. So you'll find yourself getting much stronger in your shikodachi. Okay, so we are the first one of these. One, two, three. And back. Now, very interesting move here. You set up like this, neko ashidachi, right neko ashidachi. Hand is held back just a split second, and then blocking up. Same thing. Hips are forward, hitting back with the butt at the same time. So, from the side, this looks like here. Like so. And each time the hips come forward and then as you strike, the butt hits your opponent. Because this is mostly used against a grab from behind, almost like a bear hug. And as soon as you feel those arms surrounding you, first thing you want to do is get the arm up inside of their arm. Okay? If we're too late, they got us, it's much harder to get out without doing some strikes or stomps to the rear. But if you can, as soon as you feel that up, if you get this in there, you can, at the same time that you break with the elbow, you're elbowing with your other hand and hitting them with your hip. So here, we feel it coming. The arms around us here, right? This and this are both strikes too. Second time here, so hit Nippizuki and breaking the hole with that front elbow. This is also a great block. Someone's punching, to just block with that elbow. It works very well. Block, right? Block, like so. But that move is very strange to people that don't know what it is you're doing. You're breaking out of a bear hug attempt from behind. So once we feel it, it's circling us. If we can get this arm up in between their arms, then same time we strike and hit with the hip, bam, we break. This arm comes up to break their hold off. So very effective defense against a grab from behind. So we do that two separate times. So the first one, after we come back from the first strike, then it's like right neko ashidachi, left neko ashidachi, step across. Don't bring this foot here. When you turn, you won't have a stance. Got to keep this foot tracking from neko ashidachi straight on the line it's on. Then, okay, the double block. Now, as this opens, this comes to the obi. So here, and it's push down, strike up, and back. Now we have two more of those esoteric breakouts from that hold. So first, left neck awashidachi, pow. Second, right neck awashidachi, pow. Okay, opponents in front of us. This hand is hidden, like many of our kind of saifa, for instance, the geki size, where the hand is hidden. So here, we're gonna advance in quickly with suryachi, okay? So we're here, and so this hand's going to come around, either rake the eyes or take away their guard hand or their weapon hand. So here, and it's like, and immediately, strong, hard, a rocking right into the nose, pow. Now look where this hand stays, okay? Now, I've seen this last move two ways. One most common you'll see is it comes back by the ganka points, right, outside of your breasts. Here, comes up, try to put the back of the hands together. You won't, but the feeling is that, and that brings the elbows together because you're coming inside of their attempt to grab you again. So, come back, one, drop your way, and then this is like the old type can openers where we are levering their arms away from us. So we come inside of their arms, they're grabbing us like this. We come back, we go back so that we pull them off balance, right? So as we come back from here, ganka points, drop the weight, and strong. Feel that strength in here. You can have somebody push on you on both sides and you get the feeling, okay? Or get somebody to put their arms around you or start to go around you. Get space and drop inside. Now our hands, what we don't show in this kata, is we're ending with our open hands inside of their arms. What does that mean? It means that eyes, throat, whatever, because we're inside of their guard. So we don't show anything happening in this kata at that point, but know full well that once you go here, drop down, whatever, you're inside of, you open their arms up, and now you have this right in their face, neck area, eyes, whatever, so, Taisha, you name it, it's there for us. So it's a very good place to be in a close-in altercation, is the inside the goalpost, as we say. So that's kind of, another way I've seen that move, which I like a lot, is somebody's going for the throat first. So when we come back, they go for the throat, we bring the hands up higher, instead of back by the ganka point, here, and then when they see you block their hands that are going for your throat, and they dive for around your waist at that point. Okay, so you're here, they go for the throat, you block it, right? And then, one, inside as they go, and then the end is just the same. But it starts out with them going for the throat first, a throat grab. So we're going block the throat grab there, as they slide, as they bend down to go for your body, you have to come back and drop inside again. The can opener move, the very strong move there of opening, and then at the end, just and so quite a few interesting and very effective defensive moves in this kata. It takes a lot of someone really watching and understanding what we're doing through our own practice or through diligently watching someone who runs his kata well doing it. If I had a partner, some of these moves would be much more obvious to you, but I think you get the idea from what I said. So anyway, let me run it one more time and we'll see how it goes.
Sayujin!
We got a small space here, so several times I'm having to look to see how much more space I have because I'm working in a much smaller space than I'm used to. Thank you, coronavirus, for that. But I know all of y'all are doing the same thing, working in living rooms and garages and hotel rooms. I don't know, but I learned most of my katas. I used to travel a lot for my business, and most of my katas I learned to do in the space between the end of my bed and the desk in my room, which was maybe 4 to 5 feet and maybe 10 or 12 feet long. So you learn to do it. It's very important. And I apologize. I had to look once to see just how much space I had left. So understand that it's a small area that we're training in right now. So good exercise for this is Shikadachi up, Shikadachi squats, making sure chest is out, back is straight, so that you are 1, 2, 3, 4. Do many, many squats like that to build up your leg strength, and you'll see real results. Also, coming in and back, in, back. And try to really hit those Shikadachis each time. Another good one is to be a Shikadachi and go. Let's see. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Do that for about a minute at a time, keeping that same height with the head, and you'll start to feel that burn. But that will keep you from doing this kata and getting the sewing machine legs we were talking about when your legs are so full of uric acid that you're just about to croak. So anyway, I hope this is helpful. It's a very, very strong kata for projecting your own chi. It teaches you, you start learning to do that in this kata, and you'll find yourself able to project at any time, whether in front of a business meeting, in front of potential adversaries. Those are all good places to project, to put that energy force out. It brings good people and good things in, and it repels bad people and bad things. So, from the soon-to-be world-famous Garage Dojo of Sewakaya, Texas, have a great day. Hope you learned from this. I know I did. Arigato gozaimashita. Till next time. Mm-hmm.